أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين ونصلي ونسلم على معلم البشرية وطبيبها سيدنا محمد اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك عليه. My dear sister, my dear brother, my dear viewer, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today in my show on the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, I'm going to bring the first beautiful, important thing the Prophet said, which Prophet said, the Quran said. When the Prophet said, he brings the ayat, so wahi, revelation. And when the Prophet said hadith, he said a hadith, many of it related to some ayat, to the same subject. Something basic in Islam. Muslim should not do it. Practicing Muslim. But we have some, unfortunately, some non-practicing Muslim, they do it and they suffer. They suffer in this life, they suffer in the afterlife. Something prohibited in Islam. Prevented, if you do it, you will have about 50 diseases. If you do it, you commit many crimes, almost half of criminal in prison because they have done it. But the Muslim will not do it. This problem prohibited in Islam and by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is destroying marriage. Is killing people on the road. Is causing fight and attack and violence. This thing prohibited in Islam cost the government, over 100, not million, billion pound. It's almost the same cost of the budget of all national health service. The budget, the money to pay to doctor, to nurse, to clinic, to hospital. This thing prohibited beautifully, successfully in Islam. Cost the government over 100 billion pounds. If you stop this, you got the money for the budget for the National Health Service, which is now overstretched. They're screaming, nobody. We have no money, no money. This prohibited thing in Islam by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if you do it, you are feeling the casualty, accident, and emergency today. This thing, what you do, you are committing more rape, more domestic violence, more killing of women and children. This prohibited thing damage almost all organ in your body. Almost all organ. This prohibited things brought by Islam, by our physician Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Save us tens of thousands of life, no death. This prohibited thing, if you do it, you protect many million in Britain from becoming chronic patient, no cure. These prohibited things make doctor do mistake when they do it. Do mistake in prescription, in diagnosis, in treatment. This prohibited thing, as they do it, member of parliament in the House of Commons. When they do it, they fight. They make bad law because the brain is not clear. The judgment is not clear. these prohibited things. If you do it, you will lose your job. This prohibited thing. If you do it, you will be absent most of the time from your job. Sick, abstinence, chronically sick. This prohibited thing is filling our clinic, our accident emergency, as I said before, filling the ward in hospital, because not one disease, not two, about 50 disease, about 12 cancer, the physician to mankind, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In one ayah, one word, fashtanibu, ya salam. What is this? I'm sure many of you got it. Alcohol. Alcohol. In Arabic, khamr, khamra, khamr. Alcohol. The Arab, at the time of Islam and Wahi revelation, beginning of Islam, were alcoholic. This is the only thing in their life they had, apart from fighting and war also. Alcoholic. Islam beautifully, through gradual psychological step, stop alcoholism. In a most alcoholic, drunk society. Successfully. There are ayat on alcohol, many. Khamr. There are many hadith on alcohol. Prophet saying, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, this man who cannot read and write did not go to any medical college, did not see any medical study, because he is a prophet. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam said few words. Quick prohibition in the final ayat which came on alcohol, quick, instantaneous stoppage of drinking alcohol. They say the road in Mecca were a river of alcohol, everybody threw away. When Allah said, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, innama al-khamru wal-maisiru, al-ansar wal-azam, رِجْسٌ مِّنْ عَمَلِ الشَّيْطَانِ فَاشْتَنِبُوهُ. One word, my dear brother and sister, wallahi Britain National Health Service will need this word to save life, to empty the bed, to empty the prison, to save doctor alcoholic we have today, to save the budget, to give a lot of money to the government. Fashtanibu, avoid it completely. Avoid it completely. Even the warning came from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to avoid sitting on a table where alcohol is served. It implies also you don't sit in a place, restaurant, you know, hall, etc., where alcohol is served. Many Muslims, by the way, do not know that you can drink alcohol without drinking alcohol, like in smoking. You can smoke cigarette without smoking, so passive smoking. And we discover about alcohol, you know, it goes in the air. You're sitting in the same place, it goes inside your lung. Evaporate, go inside your lung. And alcohol, if you put on skin, it can be absorbed also, go into your tissue. One ayah save billion and billion pounds, save million of life. When you look around in Europe, kept marriage going, emptied the prison. Make life easy. Save, as I said always, over 100 billion here in Britain. The shouting and screaming, we need 2 million, 5 million to do that. The shouting and screaming, and they're wasting their money in war and nuclear and all the mess they do, Iraq, Afghanistan, our money, our tax money. إنما الخمر والميسر والأنصاب والأزلام رجس من عمل الشيطان فاجتنبوا. Is from Shaitan. Satan asks you to drink alcohol. Like gambling, as the ayah said also. Do gambling. Shaitan. A Muslim and Shaitan, they cannot live together. A practicing Muslim and Shaitan, they cannot sit next to each other. But unfortunately, we have a lot of Muslims today. Shaitan having a cup of tea with many. Muslim by name. It's why you mention the name of Allah. You know, Shaitan run away. You know, and you know how to avoid Shaitan according to Hadith related to this beautiful medical subject, Qailula. I mentioned it to you before. Siesta, when you sleep, Shaitan is not with you anymore. When you have siesta or nap, highly recommended by Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, highly recommended by doctor scientists in the West. Look to this other beautiful hadith. My God, three words describe to me as a medical person all the disease, problem, suffering, death, crime, etc., etc., etc. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Al-khamru ummul khaba'ith." Ya salam. Just like that. Al-khamr, alcohol, is the source. Is the cause. Khaba'ith, khaba'ith plural of khabitha. Khabitha, harm, suffering, disease, economic loss, unhappiness, psychological problem, everything bad in life is in the word khabitha. And alcohol is the source, is the cause of all these khaba'is, which in the beginning I have been picking few of them for you. There are a lot to say. Picking just few of them. Of this khaba'is. My God. You know, from whole Islam, from the whole Quran, more than 6,000 ayah, I want you to give that ayah, one word of the ayah fashtanibu, to the government in Britain, to the National Health Service, to the doctor in hospital today. Just one. Can you imagine if we give more ayat, health, economic, saving, happiness, etc., etc., if we give more and more? From the whole Quran, I repeat, from so many thousands, more than 6,000 ayat, from tens of thousands of hadiths, I like to give to the Secretary of State of Health, Jeremy Hunt. I like to give to the Department of Health. I like to give to all doctors in Britain and Europe. I like to give to the World Health Organization. This divine ayah or word only, fashtanibu. That's all. I want to give it to them to save life, to empty the hospital, to empty the prison, to save marriage, to stop killing, to stop violence, fight, etc., etc. How lucky you are, practicing Muslim, do not drink alcohol. Don't you think me and you should go after the show, do two rak'ah? Thank you, Allah. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah for the gift of Islam. I thank you, Allah, for saving me, my family, my life, for giving me this guidance coming more than 1400 years ago. Do not drink alcohol. This is a medicine, the true Islamic medicine needed to all hospitals in Britain, to all hospitals in France, in Germany, to the public need it at large. You know, some scientists and, you know, writer and doctor, you know what they said, non-Muslim? They say, if alcohol is just made now, we don't know about alcohol, and introduced, we should ban it. Wallahi, they said that. If we introduce alcohol to our society, recently, assuming you don't know alcohol, you never drank alcohol before. You know, he's saying, if just being true, we should ban it quickly, not to allow it in our society. This is non-Muslim. Non-Muslim writer, philosopher, scientist, doctor said that. What a beautiful, great health bonus coming from Islam, coming from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know, another hadith said, "Kullu muskirin khamr wa kullu muftir haram." Anhi an kulli muskir. Anything cloud the judgment. This is a beauty. Islam beautifully went to the top, because if your brain judgment, you cannot know halal from haram, right from wrong, you will be in a big mess. He didn't go straight to the organ damage, to the disease, etc. This is the top. You need to remember Allah all the time when you are awake. You need to choose right way, sirat mustaqim, halal way. You need to avoid wrong way, haram way, you know, etc. Haram thing. Judgment. Very important. Anything cloud, disturb, the judgment. This applies to drugs. This is why Fuqaha scholars said all these drugs, hashish, cannabis, you know, morphine, cocaine, LSD, you know, all this drug prohibited to, first for the clouding of the consciousness of the judgment, you don't know where to go right or left, you know, and we have a lot of discovery of disease related to each drug today. From cocaine to morphine to hashish, marijuana, etc., etc. Drug prohibited too. To give you brief, I need at least three show to explain to you medically what alcohol does to your human body. And now only just a few minutes left. I said, I repeat, drinking alcohol damage almost every organ in your body. From mouth, to throat, to stomach, to liver, to nerve, to brain. You know, when people drink alcohol, they damage thousands of brain cells. With each single drink, 1,000 brain cells die. Just like that. Alcohol. Poison. Evil. Full of harm. About 10-12 cancer. Cancer in the mouth. Cancer in the throat. Cancer in the stomach. Unbelievable. Liver cirrhosis. It's a big problem. Damage to the liver. The big organ who does, mashallah, hundreds of functions for you to keep alive. Hundreds of functions. Liver is a big organ here under your right ribs here. Liver cirrhosis. Give us organ. We need organ transplantation for liver. You made the disease. By the way, there are a lot of people making their own disease. Irresponsible. This is not in Islam. They carry on doing, you know, they still want to smoke, disease. They still want to drink alcohol, disease. There are chronic patients, people who drink alcohol, regularly going to GP, to clinic. People drink alcohol. There are chronic patients to hospital for many medical problems. Almost every organ in your body, it damages the nerve. You have peripheral neuritis. Alcohol damages the brain. And from psychiatric, psychological point of view, it gives you depression, mental illness. And when you are depressed, you know what they do, alcoholic? Kill themselves. Suicide. They kill themselves. Unfortunately, already we have a lot of suicide today. And they want to legalize in Britain assisted suicide. So the doctor gives something to the patient to kill himself or herself. And we are fighting, you know, our Christian friend, pro-life, fighting like hell. Only few Muslims, I try to join them, fight about legalizing assisted suicide. You will have brain damage, you will have delusion, you will have mental illness, you will have tremor. Your body age before its time. You will be cabbage, useless, hopeless person. Obviously, by the way, I should be fair, I'm not saying all people who drink like that. No. There are still some who control, but still they suffer medical problems. Control their drinking. And there are many, few million who cannot control. And now we have got the big problem in alcohol called binge drinking. So when they go to pub, to club, etc., Friday night, Saturday, instead of drinking normally one or two glasses, 5, 10 glass. Give me bottle after bottle. And they're causing chaos in the night, on the road, fighting, argument, rape. You see outside, watch at night, so many programs on TV about this, showing you that girl, half naked, lying flat on the road, outside the pub, the club, etc., fighting each other. Police has got a rough time, busy, especially at night and weekend, busy with the alcohol. Now we have big problem for our waiting in accident emergency. All the nurse, doctor shouting, please help us with this alcohol problem. Filling our accident emergency, we haven't got time to deal with other disease. So many, and the attacks and nerves. They attack the nerves, they attack this drunk, wasting the medical resource, the accident emergency, wasting police effort, and many of them get convicted, they go to prison. It's a big, big mess. My dear brother and sister, I'm sure you agree with me with the first example about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the physician to mankind. This is the first example. In my show, it looks I have to do another 3 shows at least. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the physician of mankind. How much saving? How much this prohibition in Islam, beautiful to save life, save money, save empty clinic, empty hospital, you know, empty prison, etc. Truly, truly, my dear brother and sister, wallahi, I say it from my heart, from my mind, after a long life being involved in medical and medicine, and as a doctor before, you know, truly, my dear brother and sister, wallahi, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a physician to mankind. truly Britain National Health Service, every county needs this prohibition from the top doctor in the world, Sayyidina Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Alhamdulillah for the gift of Islam. Thank you for watching. And we'll see you again. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.